seems to be the better player in this match, even though Morstyle definitely has a chance against him. When it comes to some kind of micro battles and whatnot, Sensuy does have more experience and, well, let's say it, possibly even skill. And it's Alfheim, and Morstyle is actually sticking to set, and this is a pretty good map for him. Ghost one is definitely favoring kind of Egyptians, and was this first relic right at the bottom? Better hero damage versus myth units. Not bad. Not bad, especially considering that it's below Morstyle, which means that his priest and pharaoh are going to be pretty cool against the early Prometheans, which means that Sensuy will be having a bit of a disadvantage as opposed to the games before. So vision cast right at the start. Oh, oh, do you see all the golds in here? 5 golds. Oh my, that's pretty juicy for Morstyle. At least this one is pretty much safe for him. Very easy to wall here. Even here, well, a lot of golds actually safe for him if he can capture the town center in here and wall nicely. So that's not half bad for him. And we see another relic, which is for better infantry hack armor. And since we have seen that Morstyle, or rather Sensuy, is quite keen on Murmilos, this is going to be a relic that he will be very happy about if it isn't stolen by his opponent. But I would be fully expecting that actually Morstyle might be wanted to take that as soon as possible, exactly so that his opponent doesn't. In the meantime, we see a bit of a hunt in the middle together with the bears and whatnot. And already converting the bears for Morstyle, of course. And at the bottom, extra hunt for Morstyle. Areas on the left, a bit of a berries and one lonely caribou. It seems that he's going to be lonely. At the max, there's going to be one hidden in the darkness, I would be expecting. But the starting hunt is not half bad. And really, you'll be quite happy about this map overall. One cow and two extras, so for a bit of a scouting, that's going to be his quite easily. Whereas for Sensuy, what is he gathering? Caribou's on the left, close to also the berry bushes. Some chickens, scouting with the cows at the back. And the town center, basically the same situation and position as for Morstyle, so not any kind of advantage or disadvantage in there. And also having quite nice hunt on the right side with the elks. But other than that, actually nothing. There's nothing at the back. Oh well, just a cliff, so yeah, there's nothing hidden in there. Maybe there's something hidden on the cliff, like a gold on a hunt. That could very well be possible, will be seen at the end. But he definitely has to hope that there's something interesting in here. What is interesting is that he is closed off totally. And this is looking almost like Jotunheim for him. Because basically the only way inside his base, well, this is going to be walled, I'm pretty sure about it, or some house, is going to be through the middle. As on the left, he should be able to wall this part of the map. It's not going to be all that hard for him. And the map seems to be a bit more open for Morstyle, as it might be slightly harder for him to wall, but not by much. Yet again, simple wall in here. This is probably going to be running a long way towards the wall as well. Then in the middle, two short walls, and it's very easy. Well, not exactly sure how to approach this from either of the players, but it really seems like pretty defensive map, and if Morstyle plays this correctly, he shouldn't be having any kind of troubles defending against potential raidings from his Sensuy opponent, and he should be having a very easy time, or rather Sensuy should be having a very hard time getting inside on the villages. And actually, hello, there was a whole herd hidden in the darkness, not just one as I was expecting, as that's often the case, but a whole herd exactly as Sensuy was having at the very top. So, Oracle's back inside base. And that's basically telling you that he is not really wanting to lose any of them to the animals. He's wanting them as an army at the very start, as he will be expecting the shifting sense from his opponent, as they will be coming most definitely, as that is a pretty strong weapon of any set. Morstyle right now dropping a temple, so he will be advancing at like... And oh, so definitely keen on advancing, as he's sending all the villages on the temple. He'll be advancing at like 450. Alright, it's going to be almost 5 minutes. That's kinda late, let's say. I have seen earlier advances, especially considering that Sensuy will be in just half a minute there, basically giving him some kind of opportunity to be a bit more aggressive than his opponent faster. And yeah, kinda dictate yet again what's going to happen on this map, and maybe even disrupt the walling, which is because there's no walling happening on the left, which is slightly curious to me. just a wall on the right, and I would be expecting... Why would you build a wall here, when you can build a wall here? Shorter one, and more useful one. Oh well, that doesn't matter, but to finish with the original thought, why wall here, when you actually have villages on the left that are going to be open? And you might actually want to wall on the left a bit more because of the gold. You need to secure the left part of the map. There is still one gold on the right, which is pretty much fine. But it seems like the much more important part of the map is on the left, and Morstyle could be doing a better job of protecting that. Okay, so Bear is probably going to be, yeah, made into stakes. Well, at least a bit later it seems. But Sensuy is already moving in with the Oracles and the Promethean, and will be even stealing the relic. Yes, yes, this is a huge relic. This is a huge relic for Sensuy, but he has to hope that he actually doesn't give it to Morstyle right about now. Possibly not, as he will be arriving a bit late on the left side. And the Bear, is he waiting for the shifting sands? He might. He could be finding those two food villies. But also might not. So far for the military units, we see just Turmas being built by Sensuy, nothing else. Whereas for his opponent, he is dropping armory, so that's going to be a faster heroic from him. And he is, I'm not sure what he's right now waiting for. Basically just some faster heroic, but the strength of Set in the beginning is through the shifting sense, and I'm not sure why he is not taking advantage of that. Oh, that's going to be some surprise attack, because he's not even using this hand, he's just converting it all. And that's going to be some big attack in the heroic age, it seems. I would be guessing that's going to be the case. You can see also the heavily, wow, heavily defensive wall in here. Yet again, this wall makes like no sense. Why wouldn't you build a wall using this granary? Getting yourself a bit of extra food from the berries. But he is thinking that as compact base as he can get is going to be something that will help him overall. But unfortunately, he hasn't been able to finish with the wall on the right, so he's going to lose a villager. And the wall is also not finished, and it might be also giving up what he's attempting to do with the hunt, as he will be clicking into the next age reasonably soon, as he is just yet again hurrying up quite strongly with the armory and also with the second TC, of course, as we would be expecting from a Set. And well, in the meantime, Sensuy is doing basically the same and going also for a third TC, because he sees that there's absolutely no pressure from his opponent. And here we go with the shifting sense. Okay, so that's going to be a disruption of the front TC, but to be honest, I don't think that Sensuy actually minds all that much. He's going to be getting the one at the back, so the only one who is going to be minding this battle is going to be the dead oracle. And that's going to be pretty much it, because this should be really easy for Sensuy to even defeat, because this guy is almost dead and will be dead very easily just about now. Oh, come on, Sensuy, hit him. Yep, goodbye budget. And this was a questionable use of shifting sense, I have to say, because as you can see, it didn't do anything. And I'm not sure if Morstyle actually hoped that he could be capturing the TC himself because of the villagers, but he didn't have any kind of extra army, so it might have been some kind of thought behind it, but it wasn't really executed all that well. And you can see even the difference in the score is just huge right about now. 400 points. It's like a double of Morstyle almost, and not even the second TC at the back is probably going to be helping you all that much. You do have one gold, you can finish the wall, which is pretty crucial, but at the same time you're going to lose the front TC, as that's not going to be capturable by you, and with that, a huge amount of gold all around the map. Well, let's see if that's something that you will be able to overcome or style. So far I'm not exactly giving you high chances, especially with Sensuy yet again going for the front one. And he will be in that effect, basically occupying those two gold mines for himself, since he doesn't have anything at the back. And well, let's have a look, for example, at the economy. We are having hen ducks, hunting dogs, and husbandry for the red player, whereas the blue, just hunting dogs. Well, and a lot of guys just going for the cowies. Well, that's not going to be all that easy for you from now on. Sensuy is still not advancing into the next age, but I would be fully expecting that it's going to be really next in line, as he really cannot afford his opponent to be getting an upper hand in the age above him, especially with the save gold on the right. But with the whole army being composed of just animals, I'm not exactly sure if it's going to be strong enough, because Sensuy is basically foregoing advancing into the next stage as he is thinking that his opponent is in such a bad shape that he can't even afford to steal his front DC, go up to 4, and it's not going to be about the 4 limit, 4 population limit from the town centers. It's going to be about basically full map control, denying any kind of extra gold mines to his opponent, and being basically camped on the doorstep of Morstyle and dictating everything that he's doing from now on. Even with the raid, or rather route inside the base, well, he might still be doing a lot of damage with the Tourmas, just camp behind the tree line on the left, and you might be very happy about the results. Let's see if actually Sensuy takes that. So far he isn't, with armory being built, so that means that Teya might not be really far behind. He has also actually switched off the villagers. I think that he has clicked one off. And a few extra military buildings are being prepared, so yep, you will be thinking that next age is not far behind. So, how's it looking for more style? So far nothing interesting, as he's switching fully into the gold on the right, so yep, right now finishing with the wall in, and also having at least a few slingers right now ready for the battle. And oh well, granary and into the animals that he has converted, okay. Well, that's at least something. Might have killed it a bit closer to the granary, and he was already going for it, but well, yeah, it doesn't really matter all that much right now. That was probably a reaction to the fourth TC I would be fully expecting. And yeah. We'll be seeing what kind of funny moments with the Teya halfway there are we going to see in the game from now on. So, Handax pickaxe. Where is actually the economy guild? On the left, still no plow, but that's no surprise for Sensuy. Doesn't really like the farm upgrades all that much. But it, quite curiously, usually doesn't stop him from winning his games. Even though it really should. Because it's kind of funny. Usually you see Sensuy play, and if he has at least plow, he has it for the whole duration of the game, for like 30-40 minutes, and he's quite fine with that. And well, apparently, it seems to be working for him quite alright. Better wall hit points, that's not bad. Could be definitely helping more style. And there's... oh, there is a bit of an exodus happening. Okay, so Moses, named Amenemope, is leading his people. In the last stand and last fight against this town center, I would be expecting. Let's see, that's going to be a bit of a fun. Yeah, more style basically recognizing that this is just going to be a bit of a fun time. With slingers killing the Tourmas, or at least attempting to do so, and villagers having a bit of a fun against this town center. I'm just going to quickly check if he's going to get some heroic age. No, he isn't. It's just a full-on will raiding, and unfortunately, the Stymphalian bird, yeah, will be thinking some other thoughts than keeping those guys and girls alive. Yet another one in there, and more style, come on, you have enough priests, you can actually take them down. A bit of effort into the dying, please. But yeah, he was able to take down the town center, so let's see if he actually more style will be attempting to take it for himself. Well, there's absolutely no chance that he can actually make that happen. But it seems that some kind of opportunity might be opening for him. And even though more style is basically just suiciding in here, it is working to some kind of degree, because he's killing the Stymphalian birds through the priests. Oh, come on, a bit of micro could be helpful. But he's not numerous enough, and the Tourmas are just unit enough for Sensuy basically get rid of absolutely everything that Morstyle is sending on his side. Even though the Slingers are still doing a pretty good job, they are slowly but surely eating into the army in here. And Sensuy right now, yep, going through Hecate. Okay, so it's not even Going to be the other god. God damn it, where is the other god? I could even remember. Helios, yeah, that's a shame. I was hoping that he could be going Helios, just for the fun of it, because he doesn't need Tartarian Git, really. Oh my, that's cheap, more style. That wasn't because of the villages, quite assuredly. Or rather, because of the lack on the villages or whatnot. That is not what decided this game. But it was fun nonetheless. Let's see how long actually it can take. Yeah. Bit of a smack talk happening in here. And well, Morstyle does seem still to have quite a lot of Willy's extras. But yeah, the economy is kinda not enough there. And yep, finally there's the GG. And Sensuy is, I have to say, quite commandingly advancing into the third round of the No Patch tournament, winning 3-0 against Morstyle. Well, quite good games, especially the March, the second one, was pretty nice. And congratulations, and nicely played by Morstyle. So let's check the post game, where, as expected, Sensuy is winning everything. But well, at least the villagers saw a bit of fighting in there, from Morstyle. Wow, that was a lot of them dead, from like 59 down to 25 or 26 or whatnot. Oh, that hurt. And actually ended at literally the same amount as Sensuy. Maybe that was the goal. Well, at any rate, GG.